Okay, we're going to teach you how to hold the cello. So first of all, we have to adjust the height. So we're going to flip this over.
Okay.
Actually, fold it on back. Let's tighten it.
Okay.
And then pull it out and adjust what height you think it feels like.
I will not. Every time you get the bow, you want to tighten it.
Okay.
And every time you're done with the bow, you want to loosen it, like before you put away in the case, because it'll protect the hairs.
Okay.
So when you tighten it, you want it to be about thumb space between the rod and the hairs. And you tighten it by turning this lovely little knob on the bottom. Okay. So then we're going to talk about the grip. Grip the bow.
Okay.
Your goal is to have your thumb in this little space right here, and then you want to have your hands hang over, your fingers hang over, covering the eye hole of your pinky, and then your pointer finger will be more up on this, so that you pull it like this.
Okay.
So to start, we're gonna put the cello down. Make sure it's like keep the tension out of your hand. And then I want you to pull your fingers a little bit over and slide across it. Just make sure there's no tension. Okay, and then I want you to grip the bow where you think you can grip it, where you think you should grip it. So good. And then you want your thumb to be pointing up. You want basically under your middle finger where you would be placed. Yeah. And then I want you to go with the left hand and flip up the bow if you're comfortable. And you want to keep your thumb a little thin so you can press the bow. Or you want it to keep it curved, not like flat.
Oh.
So like here. So when you hold it, be able to like move your thumb instead of having it flat like this. Because it creates tension in your hand.
Yes.
And you want to try this again and then just gently like pull your fingers over.
Okay.
Even if I'm not so tight.
Oh.
And curl.
Okay.
Just kinda let them sit there. Just so like you're mainly holding it more between your pointer and your thumb. It's so it's holding it more than the other fingers just kinda
okay.
Lay there on top. Can you press the door down?
It shouldn't, right?
Okay. You should be able to move it.
Oh,
but.
Yeah. Oh,
okay. So, yeah, when you feel kind of comfortable,
yeah.
Can you climb up with your fingers up the bow? Kind of.
Sort of.
Strings, your thickest one is your lowest string, your thinnest one is your highest string.
Okay.
Your highest string is A, then the next one is D, this one is G, and this one is C. So A, D, G, C.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All dogs get eggs.
All dogs get eggs. That's good. So on the neck, you're gonna want your thumb kind of behind your middle finger.
Oh.
When you're holding it, and you want your hand to have a curve. This is awesome. Yeah, that's hard time. Put your hands this way. This way. This way. Okay. So behind your middle finger, right?
Mm-hmm.
You want your hands to be nice and curved over. And then if you're going to pluck, you're going to make an arch with the right hand. And you can rest your thumb on the side if you want. And you're going to tap the strings, and you're going to use the side of your finger and pluck as hard as you can up until you almost hit like the next string.
Oh,
so use the medium part of your hand, your finger. Start on the D string. Do you remember which one's the D string?
This
one. Yes, good job. Okay. So we're gonna start. There's some leftover tape.
Where's the D?
Do you see it?
Kind of
that
yeah.
Streak there. That's where we're gonna put our first finger when we're using our hand position.
Okay.
So each finger space is a half step.
Oh.
So like this would be D, E, F, F sharp, and G.
Okay.
Right? And then this one's A, so then you do the same thing. So it'd be A,
Okay.
Yeah. So then that would be back to zero scale. Trying to play a D major scale.
Okay.
So starting on D, so you're gonna start with open.
Okay.
So normally we're gonna use, so your D, E, F sharp, G.
Oh,
so you're gonna skip the middle one.
Oh.
And it can rest on the string or you can have it a little.
Yeah, and then the key of D.
Yeah, you skip this. So yeah, the A, B, C, C sharp, D. But we're using the C sharp, so we skip. So yeah, if you're doing fingerings, this is 1, 3, 4.
Okay.
And it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4.
Uh-huh.
We don't even use fingerings.
Okay.
We do use them, but we're going to start in key of D mostly, so we'll be probably not use the C.
Okay.
Or the C natural or the F natural.
Okay.
So much. Okay, and then, so, can you do that again? And then, but if you try to, when you do the plucking, maybe do it a little lower, towards this is called the fingerboard, yeah, so the bottom of the fingerboard. We don't want to touch the strings between the fingerboard and the bridge because of the rosin that we use on the bow.
Oh.
So we don't want to get our finger oil on there.
Oh.
So you want to keep your fingers above the fingerboard.
Okay.
On the fingerboard, but a little bit lower.
Okay.
Now, we're using the because you can put tape on it and then it shows like that
right
where you put your fingers.
Okay.
But yeah. So okay. So then we are going to try to do twinkle twinkle little star.
Alright.
So
bite your own.
Yes.
Okay.
So we start twinkle twinkle on the open D.
Open D.
You're thinking of all my strings.
Am I close even?
No.
Least amount of tension as possible. Good. And real quick, you just using your mostly your wrist movements and your hand, like put write your name cursive on the ceiling. Good. Okay, so then we're gonna start on the A string, and I just want you to start. So this is called the frog, the bottom of your
okay.
It's called the frog. So you're gonna start more. or to far from my sternal A string. And I just want you to make one big, long, okay, so then I want you to go do that again. But do one down. So when you go this way, it's to call a down bow. And when you go this way, it's an up bow. Okay. So I want you to do a down bow and then an up bow. Heavier and see what you think of the sound.
Shit.
Have fun.